Sa City of Stars, Quezon City, nasa amin ang forever Commonwealth!
Miss Quezon City, how are you doing right now?
Hi Brian, I'm doing really good. I started my day with a good workout, so I'm feeling really empowered right now. After a good workout, I feel back to myself. I hope everybody is doing well despite the amount of girls you've interviewed. Laban. Allow me to introduce myself. I'm Michele Theresa Imperial Gumabao and I'm representing Quezon City.
So you have 30 seconds to answer each question. Tell us more something about yourself.
As everybody knows, I'm a professional athlete, I'm an entrepreneur, I'm an advocate, I'm a motivational speaker. And all of this came from my experiences of being a volleyball player. I've learned so much, I've grown so much, and that is one of my biggest advantages coming into this pageant.
What is one beautiful word in Tagalog and what does it mean?
Maganda! It means beautiful. I love that word because it represents each woman, each Filipina, and it says a lot about our culture. I hope that we all learn to encourage our women and to lift them up, to be confident and to be empowered.
What is that one learning experience that you had as a child that made so much impact on you?
I have been highly supported by my parents, and what they taught me is to encourage others, to support others, to work with others. That's why it benefited me as a team player playing sports, and it also benefited me joining beauty pageants because you represent an organization, working with them, collaborating with them, and being a spokesperson. You have to know how to encourage other people. That is one of the most valuable lessons that my parents has imparted on me.
What about during this pandemic?
One of the greatest lessons during this pandemic, among a lot, is to be generous. I learned how to be generous not only with my words, by checking up on people, but also with my time. I have spent my time putting up an organization called Your 200 Pesos. We were able to serve thousands of families, not only in Metro Manila, but in the nearby provinces. I learned that if more people are generous, then less people will become hungry, less people will struggle, and we will have a more united Philippines.
Quezon City, if you win, what do you plan to do more for your community?
I have been working a lot for sports. I have been part of different organizations of the government. But if I do win Miss Universe Philippines, I do know that the role is to represent the organization. I'm willing to learn more about the advocacy of Miss Universe Philippines, to work with them, to empower women, and to believe and stand by all the values that they also believe in.
What color do you think represents the phenomenal woman?
Green represents a phenomenal woman. Aside from it being the color of life, in my experience, it is the color of champions. I graduated from De La Salle University with 3 championships in my back, and I know that this is a color that inspires and empowers and shows off a strong and confident phenomenal woman. I'm biased. Allow me to be.
Okay, so you've been hearing the word working from home.
Yes, Bob.
So, what do you think are the skills needed nowadays in what you call the workplace of the future?
I work from home as an athlete. We cannot have physical trainings. And one of the most important values that I've learned is to be disciplined. Nobody is watching you. Nobody is telling you what to do. You have to know what it takes to become better, and that is my goal every single day. And it takes so much discipline to wake up in the morning, to set a schedule, despite not having physical work and not being able to report to a physical office. It's very important for children, for workers, and for office mates in general.
If there is one spot in Quezon City, whether natural or man-made, that you'd like to promote in the world, what would it be?
Super dami there. Quezon City Circle, I must say. It was one of the most popular landmarks of Quezon City. But more than that, it's a place that I've been to ever since I was young. And recently, because of the pageant, I was able to visit and film there. And I've seen how much they preserved it, the culture, the beauty. And you can see so much. The Tomb of Manuel L. Quezon, the Philippine Car Museum, if you haven't visited, is a definite must place to go.
Okay. there's a campaign, it's called hashtag love local.
Yes, Pop.
So what local products do you want to promote?
We all know Quezon City is popular for the celebrities. Our main product is people, entertainment. But in this journey for Miss Universe Philippines, I'd really like to promote garments and textile. If you are not familiar with Kamuning textile market, it's very popular and a lot of people go. And I know that with our everyday activities, being a Miss Universe Philippines candidate, I can showcase the different designers and the different products from my own city.
Last question for you is, what's one thing that you think young people should focus on? Young people like you.
Young people should focus on their dreams. And to achieve those dreams, you have to prepare yourself and equip yourself. Keep on learning, keep on growing, keep on taking risks. But at the end of the day, our dreams are our own. And no matter how much people criticize you or put you down, you have to empower yourself first before you want to empower others.
Amazing. Thank you. Very nice.
Thank you.
Kamuning market is so famous for fashion, Filipino fashion.
Yes, because when people think about Quezon City, instantly it's GMA, ABS, artistas, but we have a lot of designers in Timog alone, and that's because they're close to Kamuning, the resource for textile.
May mga pagawa din sa Kamuning.
Suits, yung mga suits.
Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you, Paul. Have a great day. Thank you. I love Q&A. I love being asked questions, especially if it's about myself and my city. I'm very proud of my hometown. So it was a very easy and casual interview today.
Mabuhay! I'm Michele Theresa Imperial Gumabao, representing Quezon City.
Miss Quezon City, Michele Theresa Gumabao, an athlete, model, and motivational speaker. Michele knows what it means to be a winner, having been victorious in volleyball tournaments and pageants before. In 2014, she started her own Michele Gumabao Volleyball Camp to instill core values of sportsmanship to the youth.
I am a motivational speaker. I feel very blessed when people actually invite me to talk and give speeches at various events. I feel like everything that I've been through in life, everything that God has put me through, I can use and inspire a lot of people and really make a difference through that.
Quezon City, Michele Theresa Gumabao.
City,
Michele Gumabao. All right, here we go with Miss Quezon City, Michele Gumabao. We need your comments on this. Throughout this journey, you have discovered that you are a phenomenal woman who is conditioned for greater. How can you create a positive and lasting impact to the world around you? Time starts now.
The volleyball court was the first ever stage I walked on. And I know that God is using me to share my passion for the sport to the younger generation. This is how I know that I am phenomenal and conditioned for greater. Because I want to instill in the youth qualities like faith, passion, hard work, and discipline, because I stand here today as proof that these can help you achieve your dreams. And I'm here to tell you to fight and never give up and be relentless in the pursuit of your dreams. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Miss Quezon City, Michele Gumabao. Representing Quezon City, Michele Gumabao.
Michele Theresa Gumabao. First finalist from Quezon City, Michele Gumabao. Congratulations. Let's start with Quezon City, Michele Gumabao. Hello, Michele.
Hi, good evening.
All right, I shall ask you not just one, but two questions, the second of which is the same question for all five of the top five candidates. We have actually asked all of our top five candidates to pick a number backstage, and we are going to start with you. So your first question is actually question number two. You have 30 seconds. To answer this question, at the end of 30 seconds, you will hear this. And then right after that, I will ask you the question that I will ask all the other candidates as well, and you have another 30 seconds to answer that as well, okay? All right.
Okay, thank you.
Here we go. Our first question. If you are under strict quarantine and isolation, what is the most important mobile app for you and why?
The most important app during this whole quarantine was my Bible. Having faith in the midst of this pandemic was very vital to me, not only for my mental health, but also for my sanity. It got me through the toughest of times. I was able to get through others through the toughest of times, and it kept me centered, and it kept me grounded. And that's the most important thing that I would need in a pandemic. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Are you ready for your second question?
Yes, bring it on.
All right, here it comes. This pandemic has made clear our priorities, essential and non-essential. Where do pageants stand in this time of crisis? Time starts now.
As we all know, pageants are a very, very inspiring event, not only to the Philippines, but to every country who supports pageantry. It is important to stage a pageant and to show the Philippines that we are much more than our setbacks, than our failures, and that we are able to overcome any adversity. Having a pageant symbolizes hope, and right now on this stage, that is who we are. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Quezon City, Michele Gumabao. The second runner-up is... Quezon City!